Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, choose your weapon. And they said, Lord, behold, here are two swords. And he said unto them, it is enough. And he was withdrawn from them about a stone's cast, and kneeled down and prayed, saying, Father, if thou be willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done. Luke 22, 38 through 41. We have a fight on our hands. This is a battle raging since the beginning of time. It started in the Garden of Eden. It is the battle between our flesh and the spirit. Jesus said, my spirit is willing, but your flesh is weak. We have so many aspirations of what we want to see happen in the kingdom of God. But our greatest hindrance is not Satan. It is our own selves. Romans 7 verse 8 reminds us, for I know that in me, that is in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing. For to will is present, but how to perform that which is good, I find not. This is what Jesus was trying to stress to us by what took place in the Garden of Gethsemane. His prayer exemplified the battle between the flesh and the spirit. He told Peter, James, and John, pray that they enter not into temptation. Then he prayed about his own flesh, not my will, but thine be done. The disciples were focusing on physical, carnal weapon, but Jesus had something else planned. Verse 41 says, and he withdrew from them about a stone's cast, and kneeled down and prayed. The word withdrawn here literally means to unsheath a sword for battle. The disciples were ready to fight a spiritual battle with carnal weapons, but Jesus taught them the secret of winning the battle of the flesh and the spirit. 2 Corinthians 10, 3-4 reminds us, for though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God, to the pulling down of strongholds. But notice what happened. Peter didn't get it. Peter made his decision in the Garden of Anointing to fight a spiritual battle with a carnal weapon. And because of this, Jesus had to rebuke Peter, because he understood that this is exactly what the devil wants us to do, is fight our battles with carnal weapons. If you fight spiritual battles with spiritual weapons, Paul said that they are mighty enough to pull down Satan's strongholds. When Peter unsheathed his carnal weapon, Jesus said, Peter, you don't need to do that. Even though it might look like we're going to lose the battle here, I want to let you know that in the Garden of Anointing, I've already fought this battle, and the good news is that we won. Jesus said that having the spiritual weapon was more important than being clothed. Why did Jesus say that a spiritual weapon is more important than your clothing? In biblical times, it was a shame and a reproach for someone to be unclothed. That's why they crucified Jesus naked. I believe in some way Jesus was trying to teach us here that he's sick and tired of our flesh covering and cloaking his spirit that is within us. God is looking for transparency. Genesis 35 verse 2 reminds us that then Jacob said unto his household that were with him, put away your strange gods from among you, and be clean, and change your garments. I came by here today to say to you, it is time for you to choose your weapon. The thought of the day. Peter made his decision in the Garden of Anointing to fight a spiritual battle with a carnal weapon. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.